Hi guys, welcome back to our show again. This is Josh.
And there's my dad.
Today we are going to make
Shepherd's Pie.
Shepherd's Pie. Alright, so the ingredients that we've got for today, we've got mince that I made up this morning, and if you watch our future episodes coming up, we will show you how to make the ingredients for it, for the mince. And
mashed potatoes, yes.
Yeah, so we're using up the mash that we made up extra mash last night, and what was left over, we're going to use it up and make some shepherd's pie. Alright, okay, so the ingredients that we've got the mince, we've got mashed potato, and we've got sheets of ready roll puff pastry. Alright, we don't need anything else but that, it's really simple.
Does it have to be puff pastry?
Yes, yes. Your other one is phyllo pastry, which is too thin. Short crust pastry, which is really for desserts.
Yeah.
Nice
and
hot pastry. Hot pastry. Alright.
Okay.
So, we'll take off on that, and Josh is going to use...
I'm just going to use a normal cereal bowl to cut out the base, and the mashed potato we're going to do is the lid. Just
close
to the edge
of the pan. Oh, you can try both. You might be able to get through it. If not, just cut all the way around. Utensils or anything like that. Just watch your wrist.
Watch your wrist, you don't cut yourself.
That's it. Yep, next one. Beautiful.
That one
should be there. Yeah, yeah. Maybe a little bit off. Remember that those circles are a bit bigger than we're using a larger pie cooker this time. You do get the smaller pie cookers, and when you buy one of those, they have the rings already perfectly in there for the base and for the top. We're going to do another episode for doing tuna mornay pies, Guinness pies, mince pies, all sorts of pies, apple pie. But the one that we're using today is a larger pie maker. Tuck it down in there just so that it's all the way up to the edge, because I'm not doing a lid on it for pastry. We don't need to have it overlapping the very top of the pie maker. Okay, so once we've got the pastry in there, there's different ways you can make your mashed potato, depends on what you like. We do another recipe is chicken and garlic and potato, garlic and sour cream mash.
That sounds good.
But this mash, it was just a basic, straightforward mash recipe. Just boiled potato, butter, and milk.
It's not very hard to cut these out either, just
got to
be careful
with the knife,
obviously.
It's a lot easier if you leave the blue sheet on when you're cutting. Alright, so you want to get your potato ready to go on top. top.
And you can make stuff with this leftover pastry. But if you want, you could use these for small little like party pies, I guess.
You could also, you can if you've got a lot of mince and you want to make quite a few pies, don't waste your pastry. Crush it up together, roll it up in a ball, grab your rolling pin and roll it out again flat. I whipped the mash, I heated it up a little bit just so that it's a bit more. If your mash is cold, you can't really smooth it out. But if you heat it up a little bit, even in the microwave just a little bit.
How long do you put in the microwave for a
little bit of this mash? Depends on how much mash you've got, but just a little bit, around a minute, 2 minutes. We'll just close that down. Right, that'll take about 5 minutes. So while that's going, we'll cut up all our rolls because we're going to make some more, continue making this after the show.
And this can be a lovely lunch.
This will go awesome. Tomato sauce and some barbecue sauce. So we make meals that are very easy for anybody to make and very quick and simple, and you're using up leftovers. Nothing worse than making a good meal and then not using your leftovers. Going in the bin, use them up, find some way to use them and make another meal out of them. Get to go out and do some fun today. Because these don't take that long to make.
Doesn't even come
to almost
far.
Yep, true. So once we've finished cooking these, I'll wrap them up in cling wrap. Once they've cooled down on the cooling wrap, wrap them up in cling wrap, straight into the freezer. And then whenever I want to reheat these, I just get the pie warmer back out again, chuck them back in, even frozen, put them straight into the pie warmer, take the cling wrap off obviously, straight into the pie warmer and leave them in there for 5 to 10 minutes, and they'll be nice and hot and served up and easy done. And if you do your pies back in the same size pie warmer, don't go doing big pies like this and putting them into a small pie warmer.
Can you use a pie maker as a pie warmer? Or do you have to get
one? Yeah, that's what I mean, use the pie maker. Well, they call it a pie maker, I call it a pie warmer. The official pie warmers down the service station. Or you can heat them up in an air fryer. We're going to do some recipes in an air fryer.
Coming up.
There we go. I hope this turned out. Look at that. I'll leave that in. get a little bit golden on top. Once we've got all these cut out, they'll be ready to be coming up. We're just folding over the blue just so that they don't stick together.
It gets pretty hard to pull apart those stuff together.
Alright, last sheet.
One more sheet, depends how many people you have seen.
How many blues you've got. Cooling rack, so when they come out, the pies can go straight on the cooling rack.
Yep. In the future, we might make something with some leftover pastry.
Yeah, we can do that, no problems. We'll come up with something for everybody to make.
Something simple and delicious.
Oh, yeah, nothing like having delicious. Alright, we're ready for the next ones. Alright, where are they, guys? Just be careful, they'll be hot.
Very hot. So, if you guys are kids and you guys are doing this at home, maybe get your adult to get them out just so you don't burn yourself, because it can give you some pretty severe burns and it's not a very good feeling.
Ooh, that was hot.
Pastry.
Now,
if they want to, can they put some pastry as a lid?
Yeah, you could do. Alright, let's put the next ones in. So you can see how easy it is to make these. The ingredients, cook everything through, that way you're not worried about cooked
foods. Yeah.
Cooked
foods can get pretty severe.
Yeah, you've got to you've got to make sure food is prepared properly.
Always be careful with the knives. Nothing worse than having it cut when you're trying to make food.
You could also change your, another ingredient to put into your mash would be some cheese. You could put some cheese in there if you want.
Cheese is really good in mash.
Alright, guys, well, that's how we make shepherd's pie.
Nice, simple, delicious lunch.
Alright, remember to like our page, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all of them. Like it, subscribe, and
hope to see you in the next episode.
See you soon. See you next time. No, what are we going to make next time?
Let's say chicken
pie. No, we've just done pie.
I don't know.
What about fish stroganoff?
Yes, sounds pretty good.
Alright guys, see you next time. Ciao.